So who's
going to start?
Me. Jen?
Okay, so I look at Jen and she's asking me a question.
Can we start whenever?
Is it my turn now?
Can I start again?
We'll start again. Okay. We'll start again.
My name is Genevieve and I'm an agribusiness student and I'm here with Ammar, an agribusiness lecturer. Today we are going to answer some of your questions. Alright, I've got the first question. What are some of the coolest jobs your former students are doing?
There's a lot. Two that comes to mind. One is a commodity broker in the United States, in the US.
Yeah.
And there's another one who created a, I can't remember the name, it's sustainable, it's banana that's waste.
Oh yeah.
And he's making them, he's turning them into ice cream. I think it's exciting.
That is exciting.
Yeah. Okay, I've got a question for you, Jen. How does the way you learn at UQ teach you the skills you need to face an unknown future?
I think it teaches us the skills, Ammar, that we need to face in the unknown future, because it's about hands-on experience. It's about applying the knowledge that the lecturers teach us and putting it into practice every day. And it gives us the skills because if we already have a base ground coming from an agricultural background in agribusiness, it teaches us the skills to talk to businesses, not just the farmers, and that's important.
Thanks, Jen. You got a question for me?
Yeah, my turn. So what opportunities do your students have to get your hands-on experience in our industry?
Well, we've got what we call capstone course. What it does, it builds on your experience in the first semester, in the second semester, in the third semester. You get to actually ask consultants with major agribusinesses.
I think that one's also good because it's a whole, everyone from your agribusiness course is in there as well. So you get to know who you're studying with.
And it's a group project. Is that what you're going to be doing next semester?
Yes.
Good luck.
Thank you.
What do you think employers in your industry are looking for? And how do you think UQ has equipped you with the skills?
I think employers in the industry are looking for people who show a commitment, integrity, a passion for agriculture and agribusiness, and also driven in the industry to not just go, we're just doing this at the moment, but to go, all right, we're doing this, but how can we expand the commodity or expand the enterprise?
Thinking outside the
box. Exactly, yeah, thinking outside the box.
And how do you think UQ has equipped you with that skill, thinking outside the box?
I think because it's given us, updated knowledge of the industry, and it's always reoccurring, and because UQ look at it and go, in 2020 this happened, so then they'll apply it to a subject. We can have a real hands-on about the technology that's coming through and everything and learn.
Do you find the industry, getting CEOs from different companies coming in, do you find that interesting? Do you find that,
Yeah, I think it's interesting because you get to hear from their side of farming and you can sit there as a student and go, would that, you like that to be me in 5 years, in that working for that company? And then maybe in 20 years or 25 years, I could be nothing in that company. What makes a good student, and are they the same things that make a good job candidate?
From my perspective, when I see someone committed, turning up to class, doing their work on time, that's half of the battle won already. That's a good student, that's a sign of a good student. And I guess the other thing that makes a good student, and I think I see this a lot, is that when you're a good student, generally you're also a good employee or potential employee.
What makes UQ a great place to study agricultural science and animal science?
The greatest thing is the Gatton campus is geared towards teaching agricultural and animal science. It's about 60 minutes away from the St. Lucia campus, and there's free buses that takes you from St. Lucia to Gatton twice a day.
Ammar,
yes.
What do you think a regional university campus like Gatton offers to students?
We've got students from, that come from different backgrounds. We've got students that come from livestock industry, students that come from cropping, and we also got students coming from other countries. That's number one, where you get to share, wealth of experience amongst yourselves. The other thing is about the facilities that we have at Gatton. We've got a dairy, we've got a piggery, we've got
clinical experience.
Yes, clinical experience, and of course, one of the most important things is we're right smack center in the middle of, where agriculture happens. Yeah, where you go up Toowoomba, you can go down broadacre cropping, and you've got horticulture just around the field. And the other thing I think that's also important, Jen, is that the world-class agricultural science that's happening, the research that's happening at UQ. Students have the opportunity to expose themselves to the ongoing research that's happening and keep up to date with what's changing in the heck nothing. Okay, Jen, tell me, what does a day in the life of agribusiness student look like?
I'll tell you a day in the life of an agribusiness student, what it would look like, but not a general day. So, okay. You'd start going to class in the morning, and then you might have a break for like 2 hours in the middle, so you'd go get something to eat from the cafe at Gatton, and then you'd sit in the library and study, and then you'd go to your next lecturer. And then past, after class, there's also associations, like the UQ Agribusiness Association.
And which you're the president of?
Yes, I'm the president of that. And they do other outside activities like dinners, with social networking, so you can get to know outside of uni companies and future employment and have a chat to them about what they're doing or things like that.
What about learning from other students as well, man? I mean, you all come from different backgrounds, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Different farming activities and stuff. How do you find that interesting? How has that shaped you as a student?
I think it shaped me as a student because I've got to know, for example, I have a good friend who's a cotton farmer, so I've got to know about cotton farming, where I come from a property that is not involved in cotton, but now I could tell someone about cotton and about the enterprise instead of just going, oh, I know about sheep, I know about cattle, I know about crops.
But I don't know anything about cotton.
But I don't know anything about cotton.
Exactly. Now you do?
Exactly.
Excellent. Your turn.
Alright. If you were employing the next agribusiness graduate, what would you be looking for?
Someone who actually thinks outside the box, because one of the things that I think is important, you know, when students come in, especially new students when they come in, and you know, in the first year it's all right, you know, how do I do this? How many pages should I write? How many references should I include? But as you progress, you want to see them thinking for themselves, students that can critically think. I think that's really important. Jen, what is the most interesting thing that you've learned that has not been part of your coursework?
Well, I think outside of the coursework, the clubs and associations do a really good job of teaching us different skills that not just the lecturers or the courses teach us. For example, the UQ Agribusiness Association has taught me how to network with people who may be CEOs or heads of big companies and to look up to them, but also to just understand that they're actually a person and to ask them about how their day is or ask them about what their business is and trying to get involved that way.
What have you learned about yourself since you began your studies at UQ?
It's taught me to be down to earth, be in love with agriculture, which I am, and take hobbies up that revolve around agriculture and agribusiness, and to broaden my communication skills with everyone, and especially, like you said, we get people coming in to speak to us from the companies. And I think that also gives me more experience. And I've learned that, yeah, I can communicate with them on a general knowledge basis. If you could give me one piece of advice that would set me apart as a job candidate, what would it be?
Number one, yeah, is getting that experience while you're working, while you're studying, getting experience. And I'm saying this not just from my perspective, but from what I've heard from all those, you know, CEOs that we've got coming in, telling what they're looking for. So they want to see experience, you want to step out, that you've done some little, you know, you've done some work outside. They want to see you to be brave, someone who would stand up and ask a question, not, you know, not afraid to ask a question, and they want someone who can think outside the box. Here's a problem, solve it for me.
Yeah.
And I guess that's one, well, three pieces of advice that I could give you to be a good job candidate.
Thank you.
Thank you.